Railroad. Canadian Pacific Railroad.
And these are the tops of the piers. That went wandering through here. Now these things, that one right in front of us are what? What would you say that's? 50 feet tall, big granite blocks?
We just climbed up, it's 100 feet. It's 100 feet.
And so all these things just are lined up through the little bit of a valley here to form a continuous pathway through there. And there's quite a little glacier back over there. Now here you can get a little better feeling for size of these columns. These aren't as tall, only maybe half the size of some of those other ones. But down there is a footbridge maybe, what is that, 3 feet wide down there? That footbridge. Going across a little creeklet. That footbridge right there. And there you see one of the columns. So the column looks like it was, oh, I don't know, 8 times 3 feet wide, 6 to 8 times, and maybe, 4 times that, 3 to 4 times that thickness, and a substantial height. And here it's crossing a river. They call it a brook. I don't remember the name of the brook though. The loop brook, yes. Because we're on this loop that starts somewhere over there, comes around this side, basically comes right here, where we're standing, and goes out to that next pillar. First leaps off the side here, goes to that pillar, and then the next two pillars out there across the creek. It continues along a ridge that we were on over there, and then other group of pillars that we saw. And this big one on the ground, by the way, which I've neglected to mention, was knocked over by an avalanche after being weakened at its base by the overflowing river. I guess a number of times undercut it, and one avalanche did it in. This is after the railroad stopped running. We found some of the old trestles here in kind of a ditch along the side, or maybe that's actually part of the roadbed. Here's Ray looking for more old trestles. How do you find an old trestle? How do you find those old trestles? They also have here a collapsed, I guess, avalanche cover that protected the rail line from avalanches until it collapsed. Presumably, that's what. Can see a rippling of the surface where the old ties are, and the ripples continue off in the distance. In fact, sometimes you can even see the train going along the tracks.
Oh, watch out if you hear the whistle.
Oh no.
So
pink shin leaf along the side of the old trestle here. And a few bunch berries mixed in too. And this is the view they came for on their train ride. The bigger peak on the left is Mount Bonney. And that was first scaled over 100 years ago, 1888. In fact, Ray knows the names of those guys, right? That scaled that?
It was Reverend Lee and Reverend Swansea, British Alpine Club, climbed to its summit. And they had done something almost unheard of on the mountain. They had climbed a technically difficult mountain just for the climb.
At the top of this mountain, you can see there must be quite a snow cover that covers the opposite side. There's a thin white line all along the top edge. A cornice of snow still left there from over winter yet. I don't know the names of these glaciers that are coming down. But they are have said that the glaciers here in Glacier National Park Canada are shrinking. Here is a peak that's recognizable and something of how it looked when all the trees were not along the old railroad bed that we just walked along. Quite a different sight than the tangled web of trees that's on top of it now. This morning, we're up above the Columbia River, and the Columbia River here is over back between the Selkirk Mountains across there, which is really where Glacier National Park was in on the other side, and the Rocky Mountains, which are to our left, which you can't see because we're right at the foot of the old Selkirk, driving along here, Columbia River base. Yoho National Park, just minutes away from the boundary with Banff, and looking at the backside of Banff National Park, which is something that I think many visitors from the Midwest don't see very well because they're heading in the opposite direction. Here we are. You can see some major glaciers up there. Not sure of the names of these particular ones, but some of the names that are up there are Wabutik, Wapta, and Glacier de Poilus, and Emerald Glacier. So this is Lake Louise.
Oh, okay. Ready?
Whoa!
Ooh. Wow.
Wow.
So where are you, Ray?
It's so good. Lake Louise. It's pretty.
And back there in the background is the chateau. Lake Louise.
How much do you think those rooms go for?
I don't know. In 200s would be my guess. Okay, that's a pretty good vantage point, huh? With the trees there and a few people. How about right here? Yeah, it shows what the place really looks like. Yeah, might as well get them all out. I'll take at least one in my pocket, and panoramic maybe.
Not so.
I didn't do that. Ready to go.
Cool. Oh, it's right there.
It's Gray Jay. You think he's used to people? You think she's used to people?
Yeah. Not too much.
Yes, there are. Okay.
Just the kids are great.
Barbara and Mary.
We had Barbara up here and Mary.
Oops, sorry. On the other side.
Only if you go underground.
Yeah.
We're just heading to the, heading down to Banff in the Lake Louise area. I was impressed by these hills with the bare rock and bands of trees between the bare rock. What? It's eating rocks?
Hi there.
Thank you.
to Mount Rundle.
Tough thing to do. You must be on a short haul. So, final approach to Banff here.
Not this one?
Yep, second one.
Do we want this exit?
No, second one. Banff.
Is the bus
cold? You sort of can get the idea here. What's the town at the foot of the Smokies? It's not as bad, but.
Gatlinburg.
This is a lot less crowded than Gatlinburg, but there's still, it's definitely a touristy town. This is the place you come and spend your money. Hudson's Bay Company there.
Market.
School shops, McDonald's. What was that, caribou lap back there?
I don't know.
Ooh, we already went too far.
Yeah.
We'll hit Buffalo, though. You got it to the right.
I haven't seen the streets in yet. Is this Buffalo?
I think we've gone far enough.
Right.
This is Buffalo, yes. Definitely want a right here. That's some take a right here. So this is what Banff looks like coming in from the east, since we've just been to the eastern boundary of the park, looking for Lake, it was Lake Winnewanka Drive, which turns out was right at the town of Banff, just turned the other way. Of course, we weren't looking for it at that moment. We kind of ignored it then when we came back through there.
There was no sign.
The other way, you know, I don't think there was.
We went by there twice and we didn't see the sign.
Because we were already attuned to that name, right?
Camera on, there's a wildlife ahead on the right.
It's a nice view of the lake, too. Get out here. What do you got out here?
A sheep.
About to attack a car. Maybe even this rocks off the side of the road. Oh yeah, this one really is kind of working. I'm going to eat that old candy wrapper. Enough of us, okay. You do get a pull out though. I'd like to look across the lake more. Burned out trees along the sides here. This is a prescribed burn according to the signs along here.
1993, was it?
Mm-hmm. Even larger, it's a prescribed burn, several miles long here, isn't it? Somebody run up there and rile them up a little bit. 3 out there, actually. What was this called, Ray?
Castle Eclipse.
Lac Louise. Ray. Some socked in up there. It's starting to rain here. Cars are still here, tourists are still here.
What are we?
Hey, we're visitors.